and always being willing to lend a hand. You know, I remarked earlier that I believe it'll take at least two people to fill his shoes until they get used to what he was doing. His church really will miss him, just from that standpoint alone, but because of his friendliness. It'll be a hard transition for people here, I believe. You know, it's kind of incidental, but I've been listening to a lot of trucker music lately. Why, I don't know. I just found this band that I like, and a lot of it talks about life on the road. It talks about, you know, the trucks breaking down and all of the just stuff that happens. And I think that Dick must have been really happy to be in his thoughts. I think he really liked driving. He really liked the solitude of driving. There's something there. I mean, it's a whole different lifestyle, and I believe that he was truly at home there. And I know that when he retired, that was a strange thing for him. I say retired with a little bit of a giggle in my voice because he didn't retire. I just got busier. Just didn't drive as much. I really appreciate seeing this group of people here remembering Dick Hunsley and standing beside his family, who he loved so much. You know, I think he probably would be surprised at how much people really genuinely loved him, because he was a very, very gentle man, very quiet and to himself, as you all know. But in there, part of that was he was a little uncomfortable with being him. He wasn't always sure if he was right. He may have said that he was. He may have acted as if he were. But I think deep inside of him, he was very, very humble. Very, very humble. And he would be truly, truly overwhelmed at this reception. I really appreciate it. We have several people who would like to speak. And I would like to offer first Reverend Shattuck to get up and to read a poem. And then I will ask that if anybody would like to say something, what I will do is I will be up here with a microphone, and if you stand up, if you stay there, I'll come to you. If you move to any other part of the room, I'll follow you with the microphone and give it to you. So feel free to share anything you'd like to, and it's an open floor.
Footprints. One night a man had a dream. He dreamed he was walking along the beach with the Lord. Across the sky flashed scenes from his life. For each scene, he noticed two sets of footprints in the sand. One belonged to him and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of his life flashed before him, he looked back at the footprints in the sand. He noticed that many times along the path of his life, there was only one set of footprints. He also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in his life. This really bothered him, and he questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I have noticed that during the most troublesome times in my life, there's only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you the most, you would leave me. The Lord replied, my precious, precious child, I love you, and I would never leave you. during your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it is then that I carried you.
I'm a granddaughter, Carrie Humphrey. I'd like to share a poem by an unknown author entitled To Those I Love and Those Who Love Me. When I am gone, release me, let me go. I have so many things to see and do. You mustn't tie yourself to me with tears. Be happy that we had so many years. I gave to you my love. You can only guess how much you gave to me in happiness. I thank you for the love each of you have shown, but now it's time I travel on alone. So grieve for me a while, if grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part, so bless the memories within your heart. I won't be far away, for life goes on. So if you need me, call, and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be near. And if you listen within your heart, you'll hear all my love around you, so soft and clear. And then, when you must come this way alone, I'll greet you with a smile and say, welcome home.
I'm also a granddaughter. I'm Whitney Hunsley. I'm going to read a poem. It's titled, Miss Me, But Let Me Go. When I come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in the gloom-filled room. Why cry for my soul set free? Miss me a little, but not too long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is the journey we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all in part of the master's plan, and set on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick of heart, go to the friends you know and bury your souls in good deeds. Miss me, but let me go.
Hi, everybody. I am Brendan Scott. I'm grandson. I'm going to read a poem, but I want to say that Pastor Abbott, he hit it on the head. Wow. He nailed it. This is entitled, May I Go. May I go now? Do you think the time is right? I lived my life and done my best, an example tried to be. So can I take that step beyond and set my spirit free? I didn't want to go at first. I fought with all my might. But something seems to draw me now to a warm and loving light. I know you're sad and afraid, because I see your tears. I'll not be far, I promise that. And I hope you always know that my spirit will be close to you wherever you may go. Thank you so for loving me. You know I love you too. That's why it's hard to say goodbye and end this life with you. So hold me now in your heart just one more time and let me hear you say, because you care so much for me, you'll let me go today.
I'm Amanda Simmons' granddaughter. I titled this poem, My Sweet Grandpa. You loved us through and through, always knew what to do. You played with us when we were little, with Lincoln logs and homemade tractors. We loved you so much. With you, we were all number one. Now we are older with children of our own. Down to the basement you go with your homemade toys in tow. On the floor you'd play, making them laugh all the way. We all know life is about change. In our hearts we will feel the pain. But when fair time is here, without Grandpa, it will never be the same. I love you, my sweet Grandpa. I know you love us all the same.